Hello guys. This is Saeed from Extra Inch Education. In this video, I will show you the easiest way to create an animated videos like the one you are watching now. So, let's not waste our time and start it.
First of all, we need to head to Animaker website, which is the one you can see here. Anyway, I will keep a copy of the website link in the video description below. To start, we will click on Create Your First Video icon here, then you will be redirected to the registration page. Enter your sign-up details here, or you use your Facebook and Google accounts to sign up. Once you are done signing up, you will be redirected to the dashboard page here. And this is how our dashboard looks like. It has a variety of different cartoon videos and templates for social media posts. You can choose from thousands of templates to create your videos. For our purpose of customizing our video on the way we want, click on the Create button here. And then select Create Video icon. And then select Black Page, so once you click on it, you will be redirected to New Black Project page. Now this is how the interface of the Animaker application looks like. At center we have the workspace. At the right side you have the scene section. At bottom we have the timeline section. And at the left we have library and orders that will help you to create your videos. So before starting, you should have an idea of what you want to create. Here I will create a short animated video for myself. First step, I will insert a proper background to my scene. So, I will click on the background section over here, and we can see there is a lot of different background options in the list. For me, I will choose a background from the office list here and select the proper background. The next item I want to bring my scene is the character. For that, I am going to the character section over here. Once you click, you will see a lot of people different character are presented under this section. But if you want to customize a unique character, it's still possible. To do that, click on the bottom create here, and then select create your own character. Once you select that, you will be redirected to a new page called character creating section. You can use from different gender here. For me, I will choose male character. And again, a lot of different characters which I can modify appears here. For now, I will choose this one. Now, from the right hand side, you can change the skin color for that character. Also, we can see a different options where you can change any attribute of that character. So we can change the hair, face, ear, eyes to different types. For now, I will change the hairstyle. And then I will add a mustache to this character from here. Next, to make it more professional, we can use this section below and change the dress to more formal topping. If we want, we can still change the bottom address as well from here. Even we can modify the color as we prefer from this section here. Also, we can change the shoes to fit the formal dress from here, as an example this one. Once you are done creating your character, just click on the save button at the right hand side here. Now we are done, so we can go back to our project we have created earlier. And if you refresh your page, you will find your new character under my characters section here. So we can see here the new character we have created earlier. Once we select the character, we can see the new character appears at our workspace. And a new bar appear at the bottom here. This bar is presenting the duration for this character to be visible. So if we drag on its edges, it will reduce or increase the duration to meet our needs. So I will drag this to be 7 seconds from here. Which means this character will be visible for 7 seconds only. Let's preview this and click at the sense from here. Now you can see that our character is visible and it will disappear after the 7th second. Notice here that the duration of the scene is 10 seconds. This is the Animaker default duration. But if you want to increase or reduce the duration, you use the options here. If you click the plus icon, it will increase the duration by 1 second, and if click the negative icon, it will decrease the scene time by 1 second. So I am going to reduce my scene time here to 7 seconds. From here we can see that each character we can see 100 actions and impressions. We can choose from at the right hand side here. For now we want the character to walk, so we will search for walking action from here, and I am selecting this action. And to make your character look happier, we can choose from the impressions here a smiley face. So, we have applied our actions, but it's still moving at the same place as we can see. But we still can make moving across two different points. So with every character or object you bring to your project, you will see a set of menu opening along with this character or object, and it's called the item menu. In this we have an option called Smart Move. This what we will use it to make the character move between two different points. So I will select the Smart Move option, and once I select it, we will see two keyframes appear at our timeline. And these keyframes indicate the position of our character. So the first keyframe indicates where the character will start, and in this case I want to be out of our scene. And at the second keyframe I want to walk over our scene, so I will position it here. At the timeline, the distance between the two frames indicate the duration for that action from start moving to finish. So, if I move the second keyframe to the fifth second. This means that this character will take 5 seconds to cross our scene. Now, let's have a preview this animation. That's perfect and simple, but it's still incomplete. Here we need to bring a multiple action to this character to satisfy you. So, let's say I want this character walked across the scene and looks towards us and wave and fold its hands. Those are three different actions which we can add to the scene easily, as I will show you now. To do that, let's select our character again, and delete the earlier animation I have applied from here. Now we want to add multiple action to this character, using the Action Plus option. Again, if we go back to the item menu, you will see the Action Plus icon here. If you click on that, we will see a new keyframe at our timeline here. And at the right hand side here, you will see actions and expression editing options of this keyframes. So the first keyframe for us is added, and I will add a second keyframe from the plus icons here. At the second keyframe, I want the character to walk through the scene and step here. To make it look toward us, we will edit this action by click the edit button from here. And then I will select the proper action, where he looked towards us. Then I will click the green box here to confirm that everything is okay. Again, I want a new action which I can add from this plus icon again. Then I will edit the action again to make my character stands with folding arms. So I am finding this action and selecting it. So this action is applied. Now we want to set and adjust the duration for those actions. So we will go to the timeline and then adjust the distance between the keyframes. This will adjust the durations for the added actions. So, I want the character to walk in the scene in 2 seconds. And then I want him to wave for us until the 4th seconds. And he will be holding his hands from the 4th second. So now let's apply and have a preview for this animation. That really cool. So now we created a character. And we added several actions to it, so we made him walk, wave and look towards us. But what is missing here is that our character is not talking. So can we add a voice to our character? The answer is yes. Click on the character and you can see a small microphone icon option called voiceover options, so click on it and you will have three options on how you can add voice to your character. The first option is by directly recording your voice. The second option is to use text-to-speech engine. And finally you have an option to upload a voice recorded earlier from your computer. For now, let's use text-to-speech engine to add a voice to our character. So we will click on the icon over here. This window will pop up, and here where we will type our texts. We want our character to speak, so I will type my text here. Now we still can edit and modify the way our text spoken. Let's say I want to introduce pose between my sentences. So I will add a pose after the word hi. So we will click here, and I will increase the voice break over here a little bit. Here we can select the gender. And here we can choose the language and accent we are want. And this list includes many voices to choose from. So now let's play the preview of this dialogue.
Hi. My name is Sam. I am an engineer.
If you are fine with the preview, click on sync. Otherwise you can modify it and play it again to meet your requirements. Now, I will press on sync over here. Notice that we have a new bar for our voice at the timeline. We will adjust the location of the audio to start after the character crossed the scene and stands at the middle here. Now let's have a preview of this.
Hi. My name is Sam. I am an engineer.
This is perfect. So, like this we can add voice to our character. What I want now is to add a music background for my video. To do that we have to go back to the library and orders from here. Down we have a section called music. At this section you will find many free music which we can choose from. All you need to do is to hear the music and then click on the plus icon to add it to your timeline. Down here, we can reduce the music volume to hear our dialogue created earlier probably. Now, let's have a preview of our scene.
Hi, my name is Sam. I am an engineer.
Finally, at the right hand here we can see many options to control our scenes. So from this icon I can add a new scene, or duplicate the scene from the icon here, or even delete the scene from here. Now we are done, and we want to save our scene. For that we click at the publish icon from here, and you will have may option to public your video directly to several social media's platforms. Or you can download the video from this option here. Here you can choose a different video quality and extensions. Once you are done and you click on download here, this redirected to download page which will take few minutes to render your video. Or even you can edit it again, or share it as well. One last point here, is that you can upgrade your account to remove the watermark you can see at the corner here, and to get may further options.
Hi. My name is Sam. I am an engineer.
This is short brief on how you can make an animated scene using Animaker. There's still a lot of advanced options and details we will cover it in later videos. If you like our video, don't forget to hit the thumb up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.